Welcome to Lucid Mind Chemistry Channel. In this video, I have compiled questions related to the electronic configuration of different transition and non-transition elements and finding unpaired electrons in orbitals. For similar topics and question timestamps, read video description. Question 10. In which pair does each species have the same number of unpaired electrons? We just have to find out the number of unpaired electrons. So for that, we'll have to do the electronic configuration of each element. Let's find the number of protons of each element. Aluminum has 13 atomic number. Copper has 29. The atomic number of calcium is 20. Chromium is 24. Calcium is 20 again. Nickel is 28. Iron is 26. And oxygen is 8. Now, first solving part A, we have aluminum. Atomic number is 13, so there are 13 electrons. The electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, and 2p. 6, 3s2, 3p1. So there is just one unpaired electron present in the p orbital. Let's find out copper plus 2. The atomic number is 29, so the number of electrons are actually 27 because the charge is plus 2, 2 electrons are lost. Writing the electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, and 3d10. This electronic configuration is for neutral copper, as we know that the charge is plus 2, so 2 electrons will be lost. First electron is going to be lost from 4s orbital and one goes from d orbital. So the electronic configuration becomes 4s0 3d9. Now d orbital is further made up of 5 suborbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So just one unpaired electron is left. It means that the number of unpaired electrons in both aluminum and copper plus 2 is the same. So part A is correct. Let's move to the part B. Part B is calcium and chromium plus 3. First, the electronic configuration of calcium. We can write it from starting from argon, as we know that the atomic number of argon is 18. And 2 electrons are left, which is 4s2. So the total electrons will be 20. There is no unpaired electron in calcium. Now let's find out about chromium. The atomic number is 24. So it means there are 21 electrons present in the chromium ion. The electronic configuration will be argon 18. Then we have 4s0 and 3d. Now the number of electrons present in the 3d orbital are like this. So we have 3 unpaired electrons present in chromium plus 3 ion. Calcium has 0 unpaired electrons and chromium has 3, so this is not the answer. Let's move to the part C now. In part C we have calcium again. There are no unpaired electrons. And nickel plus 2. So let's do the electronic configuration of nickel plus 2. The atomic number is 28 and the number of electrons are 26. So the electronic configuration could be written as argon 18. Then we have 4s0 and 3d 8. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So there are 2 unpaired electrons present in the d orbital. So nickel has 2 and calcium has none. Now finding the number of unpaired electrons in part D. we have iron plus 3. Atomic number is 26, so the number of electrons are 23. Electronic configuration will be argon 18, 4s0, and 3d5. So we have 5 unpaired electrons present in the ion of iron plus 3. Now oxygen atom, we have minus 2 charge, atomic number is 8, so there are 10 electrons and the electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So there is no unpaired electron present in oxygen ion. So the only answer is part A. Question 8. What is electronic configuration of an isolated nickel plus 2 ion? The atomic number of nickel neutral is 28. So we have 28 electrons in the nickel atom. So let's first find out the electronic configuration of neutral nickel. We can write Na is equal to argon 18, 3d8, 4s2. When nickel is converted into nickel plus 2, it means 2 electrons are lost. And electrons are lost from 4s first. So therefore the electronic configuration will be argon 18, 3d8, 4s0. In these 4 options we have 18 electrons up till 3p6. So we have 3d8 after 18 electrons, so the only option that is correct is D. Question 14. The electronic arrangement for atoms of 4 elements is given. Which element is the strongest oxidizing agent? We know that oxidizing agent oxidizes others while itself reduces. Now reduction means gain of electrons, so therefore it means that it gains electrons from other elements. Let's find the element based on the electronic configuration given. As there are 9 electrons in A, so there will be 9 protons and the element is fluorine. For B we have 12 electrons, so there will be 12 protons and it is magnesium. For C, we have 17 electrons, so 17 protons for chlorine. For D, we have 20 electrons, so 20 protons are for calcium. Now we know that non-metals gain electrons while metals lose electrons. So the answer must be a non-metal, so it could be A or C. Now among A and C, we have fluorine and chlorine. Now fluorine is more electronegative than chlorine. It means that it is a stronger oxidizing agent as compared to chlorine. The answer is therefore A. Question 32. In which pairs do both species have the same number of unpaired electrons in p orbitals? Let's first find the number of electrons. Oxygen atom has 8 electrons. Chlorine positive has 16 electrons. F positive has 8 electrons. Gallium negative has 32 electrons. Atom has 7 electrons. Krypton has 33 electrons. Now let's do the electronic configuration of oxygen. We have 1s2, 2s2, 2px, 2py, 2pz. As 4 electrons are filled and there are 4 electrons that are left, so we would have 1 electron in x, 1 in y, 1 in z, and then 4th electron in 2px orbital. For Cl positive, we can write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3px, 3py, 3pz. Now putting electrons, we have 12 electrons already filled and 4 electrons are left. So 1, 2, 3, and then the pairing starts, 4. Now in oxygen atom we can see that in 2p orbital we have 2 unpaired electrons. In chlorine positive we also have 2 unpaired electrons present. So 1 is the correct option. Now moving towards second option, we have F positive. As fluorine positive has 8 electrons, so the electronic configuration will be exactly similar to oxygen atom. So it has 2 unpaired electrons. Now for gallium 32, we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10, 4px, 4py, 4pz. As we already have filled 30 electrons up till 3d10, so now we just have 2 electrons left. One will be in 4px, one will be in 4py. So we can see there are 2 unpaired electrons in gallium negative and there are 2 unpaired electrons in fluorine positive. So option 2 is also correct. Moving towards option 3, we have nitrogen 7. So the electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, 2px, 2py, 2pz. As 4 electrons are already filled, so we have 3 electrons left, 1, 2, 3. And there are 3 unpaired electrons present in p orbitals. Now for krypton plus 3. We have 33 electrons, so the electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10. Then we have 4px, 4py, 4pz. As 30 electrons are already filled up till 3d10, so there are 3 electrons that are left, 1, 2, 3. Again, we have 3 unpaired electrons, so 3 is also correct option. As all 3 options are correct, so therefore answer is A. Question 3, which atom has exactly 3 unpaired electrons? In A, we have isolated gaseous aluminum atom. The atomic number of aluminum is 13, so there must be 13 electrons in aluminum atom. For carbon, the atomic number is 6, so we have 6 electrons. Similarly, for chromium, the atomic number is 24, so we have 24 electrons. And for phosphorus, the number of electrons is 15. Let's do electronic configuration first for aluminum atom. So aluminum equals 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 3s2, and in 3p we just have 1 electron left. So we just have 1 unpaired electron, so therefore A is incorrect. Similarly for carbon, we can do the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, and in 2p we have 2px and 2py. So the number of electrons is 1 in each 2px and 2py, so we have 2 unpaired electrons. Actually we need 3 unpaired electrons, so carbon is also incorrect. Now for chromium atom, we can do the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d and 4s. Now as we know that 3d is more stable when it has half filled electrons, which is equal to 5, so it must be 3d5 and 4s1. Now 3d subshell consists of 5 different orbitals. First is 3dxy, then we have 3dyz, then xz, then x square, y square, and then z square. This is the orientation of 3d orbitals on x and y axis. Now putting electrons in these orbitals, we have 5 electrons, so there must be 5 unpaired electrons present in D orbitals. And as we need 3 unpaired electrons, so therefore C is also incorrect. Last one is phosphorus. For phosphorus, the electronic configuration will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. And in 3p, we have 3 orbitals, 3px, 3py and 3pz. As 3 electrons are left, so 1 electron will come in each orbital. So now we have 3 unpaired electrons, so therefore D is correct. Correct answer is therefore D. Question 4. Which statement about the electrons in a ground state carbon atom is correct? Ground state is the normal state of carbon. The atomic number of carbon is 6. So the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2. And in 2p there are 2 electrons. One is in 2px and the second one is in 2py orbital. Moving towards the statements, we have A. Electrons are present in 4 different energy levels. As we can see, there are 3 different energy levels. One is 1s, second is 2s and third is 2p. So it is incorrect. B. There are more electrons in p orbitals than there are in s orbitals. As we can see that 2 electrons are present in p orbital and 2 electrons are present in each s orbital. So therefore this is also incorrect. C. The occupied orbital of highest energy is spherical. Now the occupied orbital of highest energy is P and the shape of P is dumbbell. It is S orbital which is spherical in shape. So therefore this is also incorrect. D. The occupied orbital of lowest energy is spherical. As we can see that the lowest energy is 1s and S is spherical in shape. So D is correct, therefore answer is D. Thanks for watching. If this was useful, please do like, subscribe, and share.